विनोद खन्ना's ओशो जर्नी।
राधे कृष्ण राधे कृष्ण, किस पाप की नगरी में चला गया था मैं? वासना का नग्न नृत्य, दुराचार, रक्तपात, मानव फिर पशुओं की ओर चला जा रहा है।
विनोद खन्ना, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट हैंडसम एक्टर्स ऑफ द 70s एंड 80s, हिज कैरिस्मेटिक पर्सनालिटी एंड ड्रॉप डेड लुक्स आर अनफॉरगेटेबल, बट एट 70 ही कुड नॉट सर्वाइव ब्लैडर कैंसर एंड सेड गुडबाय ऑन 27th अप्रैल 2017 इन मुंबई। लेट्स नो हाउ द सक्सेसफुल एक्टर एट द पीक ऑफ हिज करियर बिकेम अ मंक एंड लेफ्ट ऑल द वर्ल्डली प्लेजर्स।
प्रिय प्राणेश्वरी, प्रिय प्राणेश्वरी, हृदयेश्वरी, यदि आप हमें आदेश करें तो प्रेम का हम श्री गणेश करें।
When actor Sunil Dutt saw Vinod Khanna for the first time, he was fascinated with the young man because he was from Peshawar, present-day Pakistan. Vinod Khanna was extremely good-looking, so Dutt Sahab decided to launch him and his own younger brother Som Dutt in his home production Man Ka Meet in 1968. This was Vinod Khanna's debut film. He started his career as a villain with films like Man Ka Meet, Purab Aur Paschim, On Milo Sajna, Sacha Jhoota, but soon he became a hero. In 1971, he was seen in different roles with films like Reshma Aur Shera, Mere Apne and Mera Gaon Mera Desh. Soon he became a part of big banner multi-starrer films also. Who can forget Khoon Paseena, Hera Pheri, Amar Akbar Anthony, Parvarish, Mukaddar Ka Sikandar and many more. According to the reports, his role in Qurbani was first offered to Amitabh Bachchan, but Big B refused it, so the role came to him and became the highest grossing film of that year and a musical hit.
Ek dur jana na, dooja pyar todna na hai manzoor to bolo haan.
He was married to Gitanjali, his childhood love, and had two sons from his first marriage, actors Akshay Khanna and Rahul Khanna. But soon, he took a shocking step. He left the film industry. He left everything and became a follower of the spiritual guru Osho. His first wife Gitanjali was supportive of his decision. This journey had started in the year 1978. He was often spotted wearing an orange kaftan and a beaded mala to shootings. He walked around the studios and his set with an orange cloth bag strapped around his shoulder. He spent his weekends at the Osho Ashram in Pune. Soon it was evident that he is not interested in what he was doing. Osho shifted to Oregon Ashram and his disciple Vinod Khanna followed him. By this time, he was simply loved by everybody with films like Qurbani and The Burning Train. Nobody believed that he had left, but soon it was evident to all that it was true. He had returned signing amounts. He called a conference and appeared very calm and composed. Everybody was surprised to see him. He said he had made up his mind to quit films and shift base, and that he wanted to follow his heart. His wife Gitanjali, seated beside him in the conference, was supportive of his decision. He went away and became a gardener at the ashram. There was no news, and then reports came that his first marriage had ended in a divorce by 1985, as things had become very difficult for his wife and kids to handle. People said various things about him, which was easy for him to take but not for the family. After his long exile, Vinod Khanna was first spotted on a popular magazine cover with a white beard. It was a signal to the film industry that he is back. And it was heard that the producers were lining up to sign him. His first release post his spiritual break was Mukul Anand's Insaaf, starring Dimple Kapadia. And then came Firoz Khan's Dayawan. He was also seen in the Synthol ad, who can forget him? On the beach, with the horse, he was extremely good-looking at that time also. But the stardom that he had gained before exile did not return to him. His journey into exile and then returning to the same world had been amazing for him. He had experienced the highs and lows of life, left everything and then accepted everything again. Vinod Khanna is a personality whose journey is inspiring and worth mentioning. To know more interesting stories of Bollywood, subscribe Page 3 Reporter.